meditating every day. Just you insist that you're going to meditate for 5 minutes or 10 minutes before you go to sleep every night. And you insist on it, and you keep doing it. Again, a crisis occurs in your life, and the fact that you are able to hold yourself calmly, quietly, and sit in your bed or wherever and meditate every day for the whole of your life will hold your hand, will make you very stable. So when everybody else is breaking down, you'll be, you know, you won't lose your head. You'll be very focused and firm and able to handle the difficult situation. See, it helped. So the fourth reason why we say rituals are important is because in a way, activity you set in motion, says the law of karma, will produce results, consequences. You can't say good result, but it will make you strong and firm, and you can handle things. So these are the four reasons why the Hindus say all rituals are important. And of course, the standard one that you use at home is a tradition. It gives us identity. This is why we know we belong to this sectarian movement in Hindu religion, and we are believers in goddess, the mother goddess, Shakta tradition. And because we do worship mother goddess every day, it continues to link us with our Shakta tradition. Shakta means believing Shakti. So this is why we do it. So it's all fair enough. So you see, there are the five lovely reasons why rituals are important. One is traditional identity, but the other four are equally more deeper ideas. Your parents will know the first one. We just have to do it because we've been doing it. But the other four, they won't know. If you test them out at home tonight, you'll be surprised. Say, why do we do this? Then we don't know. We've just been doing it. See, it makes us feel nice, but that's not good enough. You need answers. And the four answers I gave you are very dramatic, very important answers. So please memorize. This is very important for any ritual in religion. And not only in Hindu religion, other religions too. The answer applies. The same answers will be there. They have the same thing, except they might use slightly different vocabulary, but it's the same thing behind any work, any activity you do in the name of religion. Okay, so that's one interesting part we have to explore. Now I'm going to just touch on simple things that you do in the house, and we are looking at why. Why do we do it? Even a simple worship ceremony. So I'm going to describe the worship ceremony. Now, the worship is done in the house. If you've got a very large house, you might have a room specially reserved for worship, a shrine room. And maybe you don't have extra room because you've got so many brothers and sisters and all the rooms are occupied. Then you might just have a shrine in the lounge, sometimes in the kitchen, or sometimes in the bedroom even. Your mommy's bedroom or your granny's bedroom. But fair enough. But you'll have a shrine or a shrine room in the house. Here you find images of gods and goddesses. The images are called Murti, M-U-R-T-I, or the more posh word is Pratima, and I tell you what they actually mean, the words mean. They're very interesting words. Murti actually literally means, from the Sanskrit root mruta, it means giving you a material, giving material expression to the spirit, if you like. Something that is spirit is difficult, you give it a material manifestation, a material form. It's called murti. So you are saying the spirit, idea of God, you are giving it a material, if you like, presentation, expression. And that is called murti. The other word is pratima, meaning the same, image of God or image of the deity. We say, again, the word pratima comes from the Sanskrit root prati, which means going towards. And pratima means an image that will take me to God. See how they are defined. Hindus don't worship objects. Be very careful. That's called idolatry, worshipping idols. Hindus don't worship idols. Hindus worship pratima or murti, which are very clearly saying that we are giving material manifestation to the spirit, or we are using this imagery to lead us to God. So this idea of taking us towards God using pratima or murti is important. So in the shrine or the shrine room, there will be an image of a deity or the God that the family believe in. And there may be many, because in the family there may be a variation. Somebody says, well, I like Vishnu, some people I like Mother Goddess, some say I like Ram, somebody says I like Krishna. All the images may be sitting there. In the Hindu tradition, because we are pluralistic, it doesn't cause problem. It's fine, they can sit next to each other. The other thing you might find in the shrine or the shrine room is pratika. Again, the word prati means going towards, and the word pratika means an if like a symbol that will lead me towards God. And you know, pratima is an image. Pratika is a symbol that will lead me to God. So you'll have pratika and pratima in the shrine. And the pratik of the Hindu tradition we studied some time back are the main symbols of Hinduism, like Om is the most central, most important symbol that represents the idea of God, if you like, as the Supreme Personality, or heard through meditation as the sound Om. So you can think of the idea of Om as a symbol, and other symbols are swastika, the lotus, etc. But the main thing is swastika and Om symbol, which is the sound heard in deep meditation, as representing, if you like, the best concept of God. So this is how you have, they have the symbol Om, you'll have the symbol in the swastika, and you'll have the images of God, pratikma, or if you like, murti, and you worship. And this is well decorated, because the reason why it's decorated is because, look, we want to show respect. So this well decorated, the shrine is always well decorated and well lit. This is your shrine. Now, how would you carry out the worship ceremony? You'd enter the temple, enter the place. Of course, you take your shoes off. Hopefully, you've taken a bath, because you must be pure. If you're stinking, it's not the right thing to do when you're worshipping. So you might take a shower or a bath. You take your shoes off, you're wearing clean clothes, and you enter the shrine room. When you enter, the first thing you do is, you can have a variation. There's no fixed prescription. There can be variation. But normally, you'll see the person sit in front of the shrine, maybe put a little mat, prayer mat, or if you like, a meditation mat, and sit on it. And he will use water to sprinkle on the images as well as on himself, or even sprinkle it around the room. And the significance of water is same in all world religions. It is a symbol of purification. So you say, now before I start the worship, let me purify myself and the surrounding. And sometimes they might take a sip of water, Achaman, they might take a sip of water to say I'm purifying myself. But water is crucial now, you see, it's a symbol of purification. See, I told you, symbolic, so it's purification. Then you see, what else would you find? You'd find this person might, you know, light a lamp, a diva. And the reason why you light a lamp is because we say it is symbolizing going from ignorance to illumination, becoming enlightened. That's the symbol. And the same symbol is used in every world religion. Symbol of going from ignorance to symbol of becoming illumined or knowledgeable about God. So that's a symbolic gesture. So you light a lamp. Yeah, that's the second thing. So the water and light are kind of important. The other thing in the Hindu tradition, in some Catholic tradition too, they will use some incense. Incense means something that is sweet smelling. That kind of, they would use like a little incense stick that they will light up, and the whole room is filled with a lovely scent. Again, you see, this is important because even all our senses are drawn to think of higher things because you're meditating. So you're using water, using kind of nice light, nicely decorated imagery, so your sight is used. You're smelling, your sense of smell is also used to think of higher. That's why the incense stick gives out a sweet smell. And that's the whole room is permeated by the sweet smell. They think, think of higher things. And if you've seen an incense stick burning in a room, and you enter the room, there's a nice blue smoke that kind of like layers in the room. Have you noticed that? It means things you're thinking in a godly plane. You're not in this on earth anymore, you're somewhere else. It is a nice symbolic gesture. So you